Hello peeps, welcome back to Old Yorkshire Git Tries Atomic Heart Part 16. How are you all doing today? My name's Ross and time for some shit gaming. Right, we knew at the end of yesterday's that when I go up these stores and up these stairs and into that thing, shit loads of baddies, isn't there? So I need to change it, but see, that's, I want my telekinesis. It says in the center at the bottom there, switch. Now it's got the symbol for the gloop. Now, has it switched? Yes. Right. But the symbol for the telekinesis is virtually identical. Right. Have I got another? I've got an electric cartridge. No, wrong one. And for this, actually, no, I'll swap those over. Put that one on my thing, freeze them. Put the electric one on there. Right, I've got my telekinesis. I've got my collection. Good cough, do you do? Excuse me. Because I don't want to go through killing all these bloody baddies again.
So, what was wrong with the real beta connectors?
Since Collective was originally planned without any discretionary authority, everyone in it was supposed to be evil.
We already
excuse me.
Then why'd they need the beta connectors?
To secure Collective against unforeseen threats from individuals who might wish to control it.
That's impossible. Everybody's equal in Collective. Shit. The Alpha connector.
Indeed. Intruders or an opposition force among equals could try to obtain the Alpha connector. This could lead to human casualties, which would be unacceptable.
So how could beta connectors stop this from happening?
They didn't give their carriers any discretionary authority, but they did allow them to be present within Collective without being a part of it. In other words, they had total autonomy while retaining access to the information network.
So what? That's basically what we have right now.
You're seeing this from a human perspective.
What other kind of perspective could I... Oh, crap. Boss wanted to put beta rings on some robots so no one else in Collective could control them.
Indeed they are. At first, Dr. Sechenov planned to murder his loyal twins to guard the Alpha. While logged in
lights out,
he could control them from anywhere on Earth.
Oh shit, I weren't looking at my health. Oh crap, you know what now, innit? I've got to go through all them. I've got a ticklet back in my throat. Peggy Puddin. Bloody hell. Right. Are we ready?
Bitch. You scared the ever-living fuck out of me.
That was close.
Well, whatever. I got the arm. This looks like the right one. Let's go find the rest.
Thank you. Get up. Right, there's some stuff over here. Surprised we can't go and save it though. If I could remember where the room was, I could try and leg it there and get a bit of respite. But I can't remember where the room is. Oh dear. Right. Now you can't open that, and there's no other doors. One way and one way only, I'm afraid.
So, what was wrong with the real beta connectors?
Since Collective was originally planned without any discretionary authority.
Yeah, we already talked about that. Then why'd they need the beta connectors?
To secure Collective against unforeseen threats from individuals who might wish to control it.
That's impossible. Collective. Shit! The Alpha Connector!
Indeed. Intruders, or an opposition force among equals, could try to obtain the Alpha Connector. This could lead to human casualties, which would be unacceptable.
So how could Beta Connectors stop this from happening?
They didn't give their carriers any discretionary authority, but they did allow them to be present within Collective without being a part of it. In other words, they had total autonomy while retaining access to the information network.
So what? That's basically what we have right now.
You're seeing this from a human perspective.
What other kind of perspective could I... Oh, crap. The boss wanted to put beta rings on some robots so no one else in Collective could control them.
Indeed they are. At first, Dr. Sechenov planned to order his loyal twins to guard the Alpha Connector. While logged into Collective, he could control them from anywhere on Earth. At the same time, no one else would be able to give them orders. They wouldn't even know that they exist.
Hold on, Charles. I don't quite get it.
Map. Ah, bugger.
Would it be possible okay. to launch Collective with everybody equal, then destroy the Alpha Connector?
Certainly. But that begs another question. Who would choose to do that?
Dr. Sechenov.
Are you sure about that, Comrade Major?
Yeah. I mean, I guess.
Sounds like they're becoming mates, him and Charles. Right, now then, do I fight or do I make my way up and try and find her? I think I'm going to try and leg it. Come on, up the stairs. Let them come for me. Aha. Safe room. Save. God, I ain't going through all that again. Bloody hellfire. I think there's about eight of it. Six, seven? Shock. What's the last one then? Mass telekinesis. Okay, polymer jet. Yeah, look how close they are. No, it's totally different. Yeah, so there's a glitch in the game because it's not changing. It stays on that one. Ah, right. So you don't know which one you bloody got. You're working with. Right, that was... Oh, polymer jet. Ooh. Character. That's a tough one, isn't it? I'm going for extra health. I die a lot. Why has it disappeared? Bloody hell, I didn't select it, did I? Oh well, I can take more physical damage. I did that last time. Right, arsenal upgrade. Shotgun. Reduce recoil, I ain't got a problem with that at the moment. Increase damage. Yep. Kleshnikov. Can't do that one. Can't do that one. Storage and assembly, disassembly. Move, move, move. Move. Sort. Right. seems to be doing all right on both of them. Do I need to worry about that? Nope. Electro. Oh, I've got a brute. I can't do that one. I can't do that one. Right, well, I'm fully. No, just realised. Arsenal upgrade. Crafting. Consumables. Cartridge. Fire. Right, now save it.
Saving data.
Shout!
Oh, that was a wise decision coming back in here, wasn't it? Right, save it there. Bear with me one moment, I'm going to get me brew. Oh, I'm back, peeps. Cheers, everybody. Right. Let's reload. Yes, I'm switching my thing at the bottom, but if you notice, It's not changing.
Let's see what you got.
Better save it again. Yes, the symbol's not changing, so according to that symbol, I've got the gloop one. Call it gloop, because it wasn't, what was that one? Prey, I think it was. They had that gloop gun thing, similar. So I don't know why it's not changing. Right, did we get any new goodies? Shock character. Right, there we go. Increase maximum health. Back to crafting. Storage and assembly. Move. Move a couple of these, can't I? Oh yeah, I can move a load of them. This is ammo. That is heavy duty. But what about? Right, stun duration, and then increase damage to robots. Save.
Saving data.
Yeah, okay. First arm's good.
Thank you, comrade.
Back upstairs.
Scanning cycle. Module. Limb. Arm. Left. Found. Location, Pavlov floor.
Could you be a little more specific?
No! This is terrible. It plunged into something warm and sticky. Oh my, it is red polymer. Disgusting!
What does this even mean?
I am sorry, dear comrade. This is the only data I have available. I hope I managed to help you.
You sure did.
Whoa.
Crap on a cracker, we got more of those freaks.
I don't mind that.
Access granted.
See how many that gave us. Oh. Okay.
Access granted.
Crafting. Consumables. No. I wonder if you could, those neuropolymers, you could make them, but obviously not. What's my ammo situation anyway? Oh, I could have done that, couldn't I? 17 shotgun. Oh, better make some more. Better make some more ammo.
Access granted.
Right. 1, 2, 3.
The desired procedure.
Right, Kalashnikov rounds. That'll do us, I suppose. Bloody hell. What tough little mothers these are, aren't they? There must be something decent he's guarding. Yeah. Whoa. Four of them. Five of them. Two black ones. Crap.
Wow, a lock. Didn't see that coming.
All right. So, rotate. Right, so. Yeah. Right, before going, sip of tea. Select loop.
Yourself comfortable. Would you like to hear about whales?
Not really.
Sorry. What?
Whales. Whales are my specialty. I'm the resident cetologist here, although there's been very little for me to study so far. But I love them dearly. They're magnificent creatures. So, have I piqued your curiosity?
What? What are you talking about? You're dead.
What do you mean? That's what's going on. It was so awful. Just like when I had my stroke. Which means, hang on, excuse me, one second. I just need to contemplate my passing.
Let's see what the old chirper's got to say.
Had a brilliant idea for an exhibit. Well, it's not really an exhibit. It's more like an experience. Anyway, here it is. Visitors walk into a dark room, grab a chirper, put on headphones, and hear something like... Read this, Tereshkova.
Imagine you're in a beautiful green field, surrounded by an endless forest that stretches from one horizon to the other. You hear a brook burbling nearby, birds singing, and puppies. Lots of puppies.
End recording. So, while a woman's voice is describing this landscape, some Pachellas create a holographic image of it all around them. What's the point, you ask? Well, to be honest, I don't know yet. But it's an awesome idea. I'll just have to explain why I woke up next to that Tereshkova.
I am the perfect woman. I am present. I am at peace. A flowing stream, an endless forest, a forever blue sky. In touch with my inner goddess.
Turn it off! Turn it off!
This whale's life was transferred into a polymer vessel thanks to the brilliance of Soviet scientists. Polymer mimetic adaptation owes its existence to these amazing animals. Nowadays, polymers are made to adapt inside the human body without triggering rejection, and even replace damage.
Where's the heart gone then?
Research is still far from complete, but one thing is certain. This polymer whale is the first step towards the prolongation of human life.
Thanks to the talent of Soviet scientists. Still, this is a marvelous exhibit. May I ask you something, Major? If you could live on in another form after death, would you?
Nope, I like the form I've got.
Nope, I like the form I've got, thanks. I don't feel like swimming around in a pool of goo.
But all in all, does the idea of polymer immortality seem acceptable to you?
That's the way they want to live. Ah.
That's a tough call. The elites would be the ones who end up immortal, while ordinary folks would stay ordinary.
You're not exactly an optimist, are you, Major?
Not anymore.
Here's an interesting fact. This whale was obtained by Mikhail Stockhausen, who piloted a whaling vessel for an entire week.
I really couldn't care less, Charles.
Right. Looks like we're going downstairs. This was the dead body. We've saved it there. Pleiuchas are resistant to gunfire. Use melee weapons against them. Okay. Oh, you bugger.
What's that crap in the canisters?
Be careful. That is a specimen called Pleiush, or Ivy. It is extremely dangerous.
Yeah, I've seen this crap before. And of course, the ripped-off arm is in there too. Why could it just be lying in a corner somewhere?
Yeah. out of there. Run, heal. Bloody hell. Right. I think we need to boost my weapon. And if I could use gloop and fire on it, surely that'd help. I think it said scan it, and I couldn't scan the bloody thing. Not while it's attacking me. Right.
So, what will it be, Major? Weapons or ability?
Can I upgrade it? Nope. Okay. Right. That's that nonsense. So I've got to test it because the symbol don't bloody change. That's a bad glitch, that is, because you need to know what special ability you've got going. Right, change weapon. Right, we've got a save point around here. Wasn't there one up here somewhere? Same as having to do that again. Right, we'll give it one more go, maybe two.
What's that crap in the canisters?
Be careful. That is a specimen called Plush, or Ivy. It is extremely dangerous.
Yeah, I've seen this crap before. And of course, the ripped off arm is in there too. Why couldn't it just be lying in a corner somewhere? son of a bitch almost took me out.
Bloody hell.
Let's hope another one of those freaks doesn't come crawling out of the next canister.
According to my data, the second canister is sealed properly. And the door's open.
Have you infiltrated the VDNH yet, Major? The government commission is almost here.
I'm inside, looking for a way to activate military drill mode. Things have been complicated by a shitload of weird shit. Any more questions?
Well, look faster. Don't let Dr. Sechenov down again.
Speaking of weird shit.
Slowing them down. All duration. Slow them down. Crafting. And disassemble. Disassemble. Move. 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 Sort. Disassemble. Don't think it's helped any. Nah. Nearly. Oh well. Save.
Saving data.
Right, we've got to go and put her arm back on and start it all off. And then I think she's going to hit the fan. Let's go and have a look, shall we?
Why isn't anybody working?
Huh. Well, we got some goodies. No brew left.
What are you doing?
Crunch, break, bend, snap, spine.
Gotcha. I'll tell the tour guide I found one of her people. Looks like a med student.
Don't swim in the polymer. Repair vendor.
Granted.
Right, quick look. Did we get any new stuff? Right. Can we get this way? Oh, that's why we came in.
Failing data.
Right. Well, before we go and put the arm on there then, we got the baddies killed. We knew he was going to end up in that room, so at some point, didn't we? Full of them. So, we'll do that one in a bit. Right, as always, thank you for watching. Do appreciate it. Thank you for your likes, subscriptions. If you're new to the channel, don't forget to like and subscribe. Wherever you're up to today, have a great time. And until tomorrow, I'll see you.